Today's video is going to help out people looking to pick out their first pair of running shoes, or maybe you just don't have that much experience picking out running shoes in general, you know, going to a specialty store. So what I'm going to do is show you exactly how I bought my last pair of running shoes. I've been running for about 5 years, and let's get into the video. So the first thing that I always look for when I'm going to pick out a new pair of running shoes is, what do I want the running shoes to be used for? Do I want it to be a racing flat? Am I going to run on the roads? Am I going to run on the trails? Am I going to do a hybrid of some of those things? So ask yourself that question. What do I want these running shoes to be used for? Or what are the majority of the runs that I'm going to be using these shoes for? So for the shoe that I needed to find right now, I needed a shoe that was good for all types of terrain. A trail shoe, but it wasn't just a trail shoe. I could also still use it on the roads or on gravel. Basically an all-around trail shoe, okay? After you have the category of shoe that you want, now you gotta look at the drop. If you don't know what running drop is, it's basically just the amount of millimeters that your shoe drops from your heel to the toe. If you've been running for a little bit, you'll know what drop you're comfortable with. If you've never picked one, in my opinion, I would recommend picking one that's around 10 millimeters drops, maybe 8 to 10 millimeter drop, just because that's kind of like right in the middle. So for me, I've been running in 0 to 6 millimeter drop shoes for a couple years now, so I knew that when I was looking for my shoes, they needed to fit around that drop, right? Now obviously I can go up maybe to 8 millimeter, 10 millimeter drop, but I definitely don't want to find a shoe that's like a 16 millimeter drop, because I am used to a lower drop shoe. Bit of research to figure out, what are the good shoes? What are the best reviewed, best recommended shoes for that type of category? I'd recommend going over to another channel called The Ginger Runner. He makes great reviews on all shoes. And then also going to runrepeat.com and therunningguru.com. For me, I went to those three resources and I looked what the best shoes were for all around trail shoes. Go to those three resources and you start looking for shoes that are rated really well, reviewed really well, have the drop that you want, and also are in the category that you want. And when they hit all four of those things, write down that shoe. See a lot of advice online saying don't buy a shoe for what it looks like. And that is really great advice, because you don't wanna get something that looks good but it doesn't perform well, it doesn't fit well on your foot. But I believe you can actually find both. So what you do is you write down all of the shoes that have really great reviews, and then you pick the ones that you like the looks of and ones that you like to try on. What happens when you start doing this research is you're gonna start noticing a lot of repetitive shoes, a lot of repetitive brands keep coming up over and over and over. So for me, I noticed that the Altra shoes, the Salomon shoes, and the Hoka shoes were three of the very most common brands for trail shoes. And I already knew that because I was a trail runner, but it's still good advice just for someone that's brand new, might not know anything about, you know, brands and stuff like that. The shoes that I ended up wanting to try on were the Altra Lone Peak, the Altra Superior, the Salomon Ride Sense, the Salomon Sense Pro, Hoka 1-1s, and the New Balance Leadville. Those were the ones that caught my eye that I decided that I was gonna wanna try on. I say try on for a reason, because you can't just go and pick a shoe online, think you like it, and just order it online without trying on. That's not gonna work. It's definitely not gonna work for running, because it's probably not gonna fit you well, and you need something that's gonna fit you very well, because you're gonna be running lots of miles in it, and even just a small little thing off will cause blisters and a lot of pain. So as you can see, I ended up having about 5 or 6 different shoes that I wanted to try on. Now that you have your list, is to go online and start looking up running shoe stores in your area that carry the most amount of brands. In my case, I was looking for Altra, Salomon, Hoka, New Balance, right? For me, I ended up finding one store that actually carried all these brands, so I was able to go there and try on all of these shoes. So when you try on each one of these shoes, I recommend thinking about each one of these points. Around the midfoot, it should feel kind of snug, but not too snug. It should kind of just wrap around your foot. Around the heel of your foot, it should feel snug as well, but not too snug. But you don't want your heel slipping all over the place either. So just basically a nice secure fit. So for length, there should be a thumb width gap between your biggest toe and the end of the shoe. Foot should be able to move like left and right a little bit as you walk around. So it shouldn't be like too snug that you can't actually move, but you shouldn't be able to slide like really crazy either. You want your foot to stay on top of the bottom of the shoe. And also when it comes to the foot width, you want to make sure that your toes and And also the sides of your feet aren't over the edge of the bottom of the shoe. That's just gonna make stress points if your feet are falling over the sides of the shoe. When you go to the store, don't go at a busy time. Don't go right after work. That's when everybody else goes. Go earlier in the day if you can. If you have a day off, go on that day. Just don't go on the busiest times because the workers are gonna be trying to rush you out the door, trying to make you buy quick, or they're gonna be so busy that they're not gonna be able to help you, and you definitely want someone to be helping you as you're going. You can get your feet assessed to see what type of foot you have. If you have a high arch, low arch, or flat feet, or you're neutral, and quite often people will recommend you to get like a stability shoe if you have flat feet, or they'll get you in a neutral shoe if you have more of a normal arch. I don't really know how I feel about that because for a long time I got told I should have been in a stability shoe, and I had a lot of problems because I do have flat feet, and now I run in a neutral shoe and I found that actually my feet were able to strengthen up. You can strengthen up your feet yourself, then I feel like you can overcome a lot of things if you have flat feet. So in my opinion, the stability shoe almost blocks your feet from being able to strengthen up. So either way, if you're in a stability shoe or a neutral shoe, you should always be looking at strengthening your feet and your ankles a little bit more, because that's just going to help you out in the long run. Tip that you will probably avoid if you just follow, you know, the sizing that I just recommended, but don't buy a shoe too small. You got to remember that your feet are going to swell up when you run, so you got to really make sure that you have that thumb width extra on the end of your shoe and that you have a little bit of wiggle room to the left and right, because as you run, blood's gonna pump into your feet and they're gonna swell. And once they swell, if they're a little tight already, you're definitely gonna blister, and that is not fun for sure. If you're trying on all those shoes, preferably they have a treadmill there and you can actually do a little run. And sometimes stores even have gait analysis where they will like analyze your running form as you run in each different shoe. That's always cool, but preferably you can find a store that at least has a treadmill so you can run on it. And what will happen is then you can really feel which one's most comfortable. And that's basically like the main point that I'm gonna try to bring in here, is that at the end of the day, choose the shoe that is the most comfortable, because if you feel anything wrong, it's gonna be magnified when you are running, right? So you don't wanna have anything wrong with that shoe when you're in there, when you're walking around, when you're on the treadmill. Because when you're out for those long runs, that little niggle is just gonna get worse and worse and worse. So pick the most comfortable shoe at the end of the day. So for me, I ended up picking the Salomon Ride Sense. That was the most comfortable shoe. And honestly, that wasn't even the shoe I was going in to buy. It just ended up being so comfortable. I'm not sponsored by them to say that or anything like that. And I'm not even saying that you should be wearing that shoe. Personally, I think that if you see something online telling you to buy a certain shoe, don't believe that, because really it all depends on your type of foot, your running form, your gait. So you need to follow these steps and try on the shoe for you, and you're gonna find that you like a shoe that someone else doesn't like, and it's just all over like that. So don't believe any of these blog posts or anything that tell you that you need to buy certain shoes, because it is all unique, it is all custom to you. So these are my tips on how to buy a shoe. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. All right, so if you've made it this far into the video, it means you've probably gotten something out of this video. So click subscribe down below, and to keep getting more videos that'll give you advice and tips about nutrition, injury prevention, pacing, the list goes on. The second thing that I want to talk about is running goals. So if you're not running for a specific race, or you're not sure what race you should be training for, download the free 10-page guide that I got down below that I made that'll help you find the perfect race or perfect goal that you should be training for right now. And the third thing I want to say right before the end of this video is, if you have a question about running that you've been wondering for a little bit, write it in the comments down below and I will do my best to answer it as thoroughly as possible. If I think the question is going to help out more than one person, I'll actually make a YouTube video about it. So do those three things: subscribe, download the guide, and write a question down below. Thanks a lot for watching, guys.